This mother's reaction to her daughter staying hungry at school astounds everyone. But before we start, please make sure to subscribe to MNR TV and hit the bell so you never miss any upload from us. Also, leave a like right now. The best childhood memory all of us have is recalling how our mother ran behind us for making us eat food. Being kids, we would run away from drinking milk and eating healthy fruits and vegetables, and then our mom would run behind us to consume those. Almost all of us have been told since the building years that health is wealth, but not many of us really pay attention to it, and it's always the mom who would actually make us sit and eat. Just like any other mother, the mother of our story is considerate towards her little daughter. She would pack her lunch daily, and one day she finds a note from her daughter's school in her lunchbox that changed the dynamics of nutrition for children forever. What was this questionable thing about a mere lunchbox that raised such a huge public drama? Lisa Pearson and her 4-year-old daughter, Natalie, lived in Colorado. Being a working mom, Lisa had a hectic schedule. She had to wake up early in the morning and had to pack lunch for herself and her daughter as well. As Natalie was in her growth years, Lisa made sure she provided her with healthy food. But one day, it was Friday morning and Lisa was deep in her sleep. That morning when the alarm went off, she just shut it off and slept again. After sleeping for about half an hour extra, she realized that she was getting late for work and even making Natalie late for school. She wakes up in panic and dresses up her daughter for school. As Natalie was quite young in age, Lisa made sure that she packs her a lunch incorporated with different colors that would attract Natalie and persuade her to eat it. She would add fruits and sandwiches with some salad. But as that day she was running late, she did not have enough time to prepare all this stuff, and thus packs her lunch with whatever she had handy, along with some biscuits. She didn't know that a sudden change in her daughter's lunch would cost her a lot. It was just another day for Lisa. She drove to her office and dropped Natalie to her school on the way. While she picked up Natalie in the noon, she was tensed. Natalie was hungry and wanted to eat something. Lisa was confused, as she had packed her lunch. Then how come her daughter was this hungry? She thought that Natalie did not have her lunch that day. While driving back home, Lisa asked Natalie about her day at school. Usually, she would very excitedly tell her mother about the activity she did at school. But that day, Natalie sounded low and irritated. When asked if she had had her lunch or not, Natalie told her that she did not eat her lunch that day. But why? Did something happen at her school? On entering the home, Natalie once again asked Lisa, "Mom, I'm hungry." Lisa was surprised, as Natalie never felt this hungry before at this time of day. To make sure that she had her lunch today, Lisa opens her lunchbox and was surprised to find a note in it, along with the pack of biscuits she packed in today. What was the note about? Aurora's Children's Academy was one of the most prestigious schools in Colorado. It shared a good name and fame in the society. When Lisa saw a note in her daughter's lunchbox from the school, she was taken aback by what was written in it. She never thought that the school, which she always bragged about, would make her rethink her decision. Of course, any mother would want the best for her children. Right from imparting education to good manners and healthy eating habits, Lisa gave the best of everything to Natalie. She knew that if she shapes Natalie's forming years in the best way possible, her future would itself turn bright. Thinking on the same lines, she admitted Natalie to this school. Little did she know that the school would do the unthinkable. As a single mother, Lisa made sure that she provided Natalie with the best. And to an extent, Lisa was even successful in doing this, as she never heard any sort of complaints regarding Natalie from school. She was good at studies and even at extracurricular activities. When a complaint came from the school regarding Natalie, Lisa had no other choice but to talk to school authorities. Lisa had absolutely no clues that a lunchbox to her daughter's school would end up making her a part of the huge public drama. Usually, she would pack healthy snacks like fruit salad, bread, jam, or cheese in her lunch. But that day, because she was rushing, she packed her a pack of biscuits, and it turned into a controversial debate all over the school and media. Lisa decides to share the note she received in Natalie's lunchbox on the social media and tell all the other parents sending their children to this school about the type of letter they send to parents. Lisa was highly disappointed to find such a letter. As a parent, she knew what was good for her child and what was not, while the letter she received somewhere pointed towards her to be an irresponsible parent. The note at which Lisa was this annoyed read something like, "It is very important that all students have a nutritious lunch. It is a public school setting and all children are required to have fruit, a vegetable, and a healthy snack from home." For an instant, Lisa was confused, as she always packed a healthy lunch for her. But that was not all. The lines in the note further took Lisa's anger to another level. The note further told parents in a very firm manner that potatoes, peanut butter, chips are not lunchable snacks. Even if the children have potatoes, they need bread to go with it. Lisa was annoyed to see that the school calls pieces of bread and potatoes as healthy and didn't let Natalie eat the biscuits in her lunch that day. Lisa wanted to take some action against it and generate some awareness. Lisa took to her social media platform and posted the notice everywhere. Her friends and other parents supported her, saying that the school could not tell the parents what a child should be fed at lunch. Moreover, keeping Natalie hungry in the name of not getting a healthy lunch was totally unacceptable to everyone. The school wasn't wrong on their behalf as well. They wanted to be sure that the children remained safe from obesity issues. They were concerned about child obesity at such an early age and thus wanted that the children should be provided with nutritious and healthy lunchboxes. Obesity is a rising concern nationwide. In the last few years, the number of children to cross the obesity line have increased. While obesity was seen as a disease to hit the adults, it is now seen amongst kids as well. Children are facing a lot of health issues and cardiovascular problems, and suffering such diseases as a kid is not an appreciable thing. Yet these statements fell on deaf ears. Lisa further argues with the school authorities that the biscuits weren't that unhealthy an option, as the school made it to be. On the first hand, the school doesn't provide children with food, and on the second one, they question what the child brings. She further makes a comment that is the same school which asks parents to send candies on occasion from time to time. As a body of the educational institution, it is a school's prime responsibility to impart healthy eating habits in children, and the parents are expected to participate in imparting such habits to their children. Being a mother, all these arguments did not bother her, and all she thought of was how did the school let Natalie stay hungry during the entire day. The school authorities said that they are considerate about every student of theirs, and they even offered Natalie a healthy snack option. They gave her some fruits, but Natalie did not wish to consume those. She wanted the biscuits only. Was it right on the part of the school to devoid a little girl of biscuits? The school made a valid comment. They said many studies show that fruit and vegetables, along with the right amount of cereals, ensure a healthy brain. These foods are believed to boost the cognitive skills of a child, while the junk and deep-fried foods, chocolates, and other sweeteners hinder with that growth. To ensure a healthy child, it is a must that they eat healthy as well. While the school made all its points sound valid, they made a statement that no parent would ever want to hear. Till the time they were talking about health and fitness goals for kids, it was agreeable. Even a specific diet for children was acceptable, but the school called Lisa unfit, which was when Lisa lost her control. Lisa, till now, was accepting everything on the part of the school. She was happy to know that the school is promoting healthy eating amongst kids, but her sole reason for the disagreement was the way the school authorities were taking this argument. Somewhere, they made Lisa feel ashamed about herself and her body structure, as she was quite obese. Lisa even tells them that this is something which has nothing to do with the discussion, and they can't even tell her this in front of her daughter. Every claim and argument which the school kept forward upsets Lisa to the extreme. She was disturbed by being told that she was to follow certain health guidelines while preparing lunch for her daughter. She says, "What the school thinks is healthy for her is not what I think is healthy for her. The school, at any cost, can't tell her what her daughter could eat and what she couldn't." The court would not have favored Natalie had she weighed beyond 100 pounds and crossed the obesity parameters. But luckily, that wasn't the case. Natalie was absolutely healthy and wasn't obese. Rather, she weighed just apt in accordance with her age. This made school's argument weak on their part and eventually left Lisa happy. The results of her daughter's perfectly fine health made Lisa even happier. Natalie was slim and disease-free. On this, Lisa further states that being a mother, she herself is concerned about Natalie's health, and she did not offer biscuits to the entire class, and the biscuits were not even the only thing in the lunch she packed. In an interview, Lisa even calls the school and the concerned staff hypocrites. She completely condemns the school's say of offering a healthy meal to their children, as they themselves offer children candies, sweets, and junk food at times. She believes that this is sheer hypocrisy on their behalf. First practice and then preach. Lisa further says that children are in an age that every time one cannot feed them vegetables, rather parents need to prepare interesting dishes incorporating vegetables and fruits. Lisa also said in a session that Natalie has a full and healthy lunch packed with fruits and vegetables and at times cereals as well. Moreover, it was Friday, so why not offer kids some treat? Schools have never had a good reputation for serving children the healthiest foods. Rather, they too would offer sandwiches and packed foods to kids. Keeping that in mind, if Lisa packed a pack of biscuits in her daughter's lunch, it should not have been such a big controversy. After all, biscuits at any time are healthier than junk food. When this entire issue was highlighted in public, Brenda Dean was the director of the school then. She shows her sympathy towards Lisa and assures her that she is looking into the matter and was trying to figure out who kept that letter in Natalie's lunch, as it was something against the institution's policies. While a majority of the public supported Lisa, there were a handful of them who even say that this entire case was a result of overreactions from both parties. The case was not such a big issue as it is depicted to be. There was no requirement of involving media into this matter. Could have been sorted out between the school authorities and the family concerned. Patty Moon, who is the chief communications officer at Aurora Public Schools, clarified on his end that as a school, it is their responsibility to promote healthy eating choices amongst kids, as well as motivate the parents to do so as well. And as far as Natalie's returning home empty stomach is concerned, she was actually offered another snack to eat. Natalie, on being offered a healthier fruit snack, refused to consume it only because she was devoid of her biscuits. And neither was this the case that the biscuits were taken away from her and thrown into the trash. No. Amongst the 100 other students at the school, it was solely Natalie's decision to stay with an empty stomach. As the preschool is the building age of the children, it is important that preschoolers are provided with healthy and nutrient-dense food. Colorful fruits and some vegetable sandwiches, along with rice and curries, are a healthy meal option for kids. Also, providing them with protein in the form of milkshakes and curd is a good choice. Often parents are confused when it comes to nutritious food for children, especially in lunchboxes. To make this a little easy, two California women introduced a ready-made packed food packet for kids. These food packs were known as Revolution Kits and are believed to be low in sodium and absolutely preservative-free. Lisa appreciated this new lunching option, but at the same time, she wants parents to provide their children with healthy and freshly made food. Instead of quantity, quality food should be focused upon. Not only Lisa, but all the parents should be particular about the meal pattern for their kids. With time, the matter sorted out between both the parties. While Lisa agreed that she should provide a healthy meal, the school also reverted in the same manner. Natalie now stepped into the elementary school and is living a healthy lifestyle. However, the school made a special remark. The Children's Academy even said that now they won't be sending any such letters to parents. It is up to parents what they want to feed their child, but all they hope is the kids are provided with nutrient-dense foods. Lisa and Natalie are doing good in life now. We hope they continue to spend a healthy, wealthy, and happy future. With this incident, we all hope that all the parties concerned and the families who saw this would start giving more importance to their fitness and health.